should be go. Should be good to go anytime. So just count down whenever you're ready.
All right. I guess 3, 2, 1, go. All right. So here, even on the file selection screen, you can do a little trick where you can make Rez kind of float over the edge of his bed by interrupting the animation. That's just a fun little thing that does nothing really. And then we quit out back to the main menu and reload into the file to skip the tutorial and all the talking and explaining. Awesome. That wasn't supposed to happen, but it doesn't make a big deal. Red Blast, hey. Okay. Load back into the... And now we can actually start playing the game. So right now, we don't have any power-ups. So our only movement options are just walking around with Raz and abusing bunny hops like I did right there, and flips like this. Flips are faster than walking. Let me go into the first tutorial level, which is basic braining. So basically this level just teaches you what's inside of people's minds and movement mechanics. So basically these figments I'm collecting, by the end of the run I'm going to need rank 20. And all these figments give me parts of a rank. Every 100 value of figments I get one rank. So I'm going to need to be collecting figments, but obviously there's a ton of them in this game, so I'm obviously skipping a lot of them too. But basically this level is just go through it as fast as you can. Because right now we just want to get the levitation ball and other stuff at the end of the game. Ah, I almost had that one. Okay, climbing stuff like this, ladders and ropes like this, jumping and re-grabbing is actually faster than just climbing. It's kind of wonky, but it works. Alright, and then after this is the worst part of this level. If you listen, you'll know why. But unfortunately, completely unskippable. Yeah. This is a combination of RNG and those two up there won't stop yelling at you. We just punch the babies to get rid of them so it spawns the next thing, because who cares about babies? Here we can kind of skip the minigame of hiding behind cover by just going faster than it can aim at us. Okay, and coming up here is going to be the first palm bomb, I guess is what we call them. But since we don't have a levitation ball or any way to speed up our movement, what we can do is, on slopes, if you ground pound, and then like immediately jump out of the ground pound, you get your downward speed from the ground pound and you can transfer it into horizontal speed, which I'll be showing right on this next ledge. And that allows us to skip basically that whole section. That's used a few times during the run. Alright, and this next room is supposed to be kind of an auto-scroller. We have to wait for the room to rotate around and follow this zigzaggy path, but if you're quick, you don't have to do that. You can just skip over to the other ledge like that. Hello? And that's the end of basic braiding.
Hello? Guess I'm early.
And here we do another palm bomb to skip over the top of these two girls, because they want to steal your money, but we don't want to talk to them. Alright, and then we go up to the roof here. In the overworld, there's cards that are spawned. But you need 9 cards, plus you have to buy an item from the shop and go somewhere and turn them in to get a rank. But that item I just picked up is a rank by itself, so those items are really good. We pick up as many as we can that aren't out of the way. Right there, I just ran into a wall so I can unlock the tram. We're also getting arrowheads and some of these scavenger hunt items. Because 8 scavenger hunt items is 4 ranks. So it's another way to get a good amount of ranks. As far as the ranks go, you get a new power up at 10, 20, and 30. And then after that, every 5 or so, you get some sort of upgrade to your powers. But we only need the 10 and 20 powers. We can skip the one at 30 by doing some neat tricks.
So what are we gonna learn?
Alright, so here's the brain tumbler level. This level we have to come back to 3 different times, just because of the way this game works. But this level also has figments that are worth 9 each, so collecting figments in this level is really important, because you have to collect a lot less per rank. And I'm also trying to get to 50 arrowheads. I'm a little bit behind right now. But we need 50 arrowheads to buy the dowsing rod. And then we can use the dowsing rod to get arrowheads to buy anything else we would need. So here we have to go get taught how to shoot things. And now we can go to Agent 9's mind, the shooting gallery.
Well done, Rod. Well done, Rod. Good.
So this first part's pretty easy, you just shoot the things when they pop up. And now you have to go from side to side and shoot 2 targets on each side. But, like this, there's obviously kind of wonky ways you can shoot these without doing intended strats. That guy likes to suicide and take your shot instead of the target. Not a big deal. That target's like the worst one, so I kind of played it safe there. And if it's jumping from side to side like that, you can get a lot of height just because of the way gravity works. And here I'm gonna jump up and get a ton of height so I can just shoot that one from all the way across the stage. Alright, so the boss fight is go around to every side and shoot the targets, so otherwise he regenerates health. and then you just dodge and punch. Sometimes he keeps attacking you, sometimes he gets distracted and runs away. I don't know why. Alright, so back to this level that we already did part of. But now I can shoot things. I get the figments on this side now. There, so now we can get past this part of the level. See if I can get a speed boost here. Nah. That one's kind of weird, but if you don't get it first try, it's not really worth trying again. So this level's really linear. You just gotta run through it, pick up as many figments as you can that aren't out of the way. Oh man, he sniped me. Ah.
Don't worry, Dogen. I'm coming up there to save you.
What is wrong, Rasputin?
All right, and then we climb up here. I gotta climb this spooky door until we get to the trigger that says we can't beat this level yet. Come back later, and it kicks us out. So now we have the oarsman's badge, which means you can use the canoe. But we don't actually need the canoe. We just need the oarsman's badge. So Mila lets us into her mind. Oh man. Alright. So we can skip the canoe by doing that. And we finally have a levitation ball, which means movement gets a lot quicker, a lot more fun. A lot less mechanical. Alright, and you can do some pretty cool things with momentum, like you'll see in this room. And here's the first instance of flying. So basically, every time Raz takes the ball and puts it like over his head and then under his feet, he gains a little bit of height. So if you do it fast enough, you'll gain height faster than you lose it. So it's just literally flying. So we can skip a lot of stuff in this level, and it comes in handy. Some of the later levels are only like 2 minutes long because of it. I said levitation ball was quicker movement, but right now I'm going to prove that wrong, I guess, by bunny hopping down these slopes, because you keep your forward momentum, and then by jumping on a downward slope, you actually kind of, you get your forward momentum, and then you like add some of your downward momentum in to it every jump. So if you can get a good chain of bunny hops here, you can get really good speed. This part of I'm just going to play it safe here so I don't... There's so many of those bumpers. Then here, if you just jump up and hit these, you basically just win the race. Alright. And another instance where flying lets us skip a little bit. Still have to go through and do all these, the actual requirements to beat the level like normal. But we don't have to do them how the game wanted us to do it. Alright, so there's Mila's mind down. And now we can use the levitation ball outside of her mind. Get a rank here and a scavenger hunt item. And we go to the main lodge. So this is kind of the big overworld section of the game, which is getting the rest of the scavenger hunt items. And we're gonna buy the dowsing rod. So you can see the cobweb duster costs 800 there, and we need it to beat the game. But instead of collecting 800 arrowheads, we're just gonna get that 50 and use the dowsing rod to find the rest. You see, even with the ball, like how you jump off slopes, like really determines your jump. So if you can jump off like a steep slope, you'll get a ton more horizontal speed. So you always try to do that, but some places there's not really much to work with. Alright, so now we go back into Brain Tumbler for the third time, final time. We can actually fight the boss now. Yeah, grinding out arrowheads would be a real pain if you actually had to get 800 without the dowsing rod. Or without the dowsing rod underwater caches. TV. Because they do respawn when you like leave and enter a zone, but I'm pretty sure most of them do. But still, you only get like less than 10 for the ones you can see, and the ones you can use the dowsing rod are like 20 to 30, I think. So, yeah, it would take forever. This boss is basically, he shoots twice when you shoot and punch him. Not a whole lot to do, but keep your eye out for ammo drops if you need them. Now let's try to set them up so the final hit, I can position them into a good spot for the second phase. You know, I kind of want to. He always tries to keep a certain distance away so you can back him up into where you want him to go. Okay, I don't want you to look more this way. I want him to fall onto a hill like this. I don't know if this will work. Sometimes while he's flying away, you can get an extra hit if he's up against a hill like that. Alright, so that's the end of that boss. And then, there's a lot of cutscenes there, but we're gonna skip them all, but basically, now this is like the second half of the game, second phase of the game. It's nighttime, Everything's different. You know who's the bad guy now. So we have to go across the lake, but the way we're gonna do that is go under the lake. Ooh, I got good RNG. This boss spawns two boxes and you have to get an RNG third one, which that very first one I punched. That item can be anything. Lucky I got a box. Oops, don't waste my ammo. So this part is the worst part of the game. It's a big auto-scroller interjected with RNG boss fights. So, you know, tons of fun. Every speedrunner's dream. But it's like it happens exactly at the middle point of the run, too. But as you see there, I just got 450 arrowheads at once. So that 50 spent on the dowsing rod was 50 well spent. You just gotta wait for the bubble to move. Which, it has one speed. Unless, if you fall into the water, if you fall outside the bubble, the game slows it down because it thinks you're having trouble and it tries to like handicap it for you. So if you're bad and you fall into the water, that loses time, and then the whole auto-scroller slows down. So you lose more time. Which, thankfully, it's you should never, ever fall into the water. So it's not a problem. Unless you just don't pay attention. Could use some more ammo, though. Alright. So here she spits out 7 items, I think. I want 3 nail boxes. Okay. Alright. Okay. That one's in the middle of nowhere, but I got 3. So here, even though I got 3 boxes, it's not the greatest RNG, because I have to go chase this box down. Where is it? There it is. But if you don't get 3 boxes, you have to like hope and pray that one of the extra items that just gets spawned and sucked in is a box. Otherwise, after about, I don't know, like 7 seconds of inhaling, she'll stop and then exhale again, and you have to, it costs a little over 20 seconds, and it's 100% RNG. But we're done with the RNG now. We're 2/3 done with the auto-scroller. This is the rail of death. If you slide on that rail, it instead of like letting you off in the bottom, you just slide into the ground and you get stuck in the ground. So that's great game design right there. I'm gonna have to be kind of conservative on my ammo here. But there's another cache of 450 arrowheads up here. Which gives me more than enough to afford the 800. Alright. End of the auto-scroller. Last third of the boss fight. basically just run up to Clam, get her stuck, punch, 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 then go to a different Clam. And hope nothing falls on your head here, otherwise you get knocked back and might miss a cycle. I'm just gonna punch this to save ammo. Alright. This level is another one where figments are worth 9 each, I'm pretty sure. Some of them are worth 9. But figments are worth a lot, so... Oop. Come on. So getting my rank up to 20, this level's important. I want to be about rank 18 and a half by the time I'm done with this level, which I am kind of over leveled, so it shouldn't be any problem. Stop targeting things. This is another problem, is this level you can't use the levitation ball. For movement, you have to flip to move, and the only way to use the flip movement is to target. So if the game decides you wanted to target a tank, it completely messes up your camera. Alright, I have way too many figments, but that's better than the opposite. My boy Demolition. That's me. I have a quarter health. Oh man. How did I manage this? Okay. Kind of skip those cutscenes slowly, otherwise the game softlocks and doesn't spawn these airplanes. I have a really bad feeling I'm gonna die here. From behind! What a guy. What a guy. No! Okay. I thought I could make that. That was my fault. I was kind of stupid and got hit by the big cannon, so I had no health to do this part. Alright. Boss fight time. Alright. So now you can do two different attacks on this part. Lets us know which attack he's using, which is, you know, pretty nice. No, that's the wrong one. Not Mighty Ram. There we go. So normally you have to reflect that 3 times, but you can actually reflect it and then shoot him twice really quickly before he puts his shield back on. And then, instead of having to do it 3 times, you can just go to it 1 cycle. And here, he's supposed to fly back up in the air, but if you back him against a wall, he tries to fly up and then runs into the wall, and then just stays on the ground instead. So you can get 1 cycle in the air and then 1 cycle in the ground. Normally that boss fight would be much longer. Alright, there's my last rank that I need. And into the Milkman level. So this is a lot of people's like favorite level casually, but I'm gonna beat it in about 2 minutes, so get your fill of it while you can. And skip all of the items. You just fly across this part while being kind of careful of the death triggers, by the way this level's set up. And then, instead of being a sewer worker, we're just gonna go underground and jump into the loading zone. Poor Jim. They got Jim.
Stop. This is a restricted area.
And then we can skip that part by just flying around him. And we're on our way to the final boss of this level. We skipped both mini-boss fights, all the item collection quests. Basically everything. Yeah, I have a lot of extra figments here. I wanted to be safe because it's a marathon run. Normally I would be like just over rank 20 here. Alright. I don't condone child violence, but she's gotta go. Alright, so 3 hits just like that in the first phase. Second phase, same thing, but camera is the boss's point of view. And here she's probably gonna jump away. Yeah, she likes to do that. There we go, end of the level. Alright, so we're rank 20. I said I needed rank 20 by the end of the run. We needed it when you enter this level, actually, but we're gonna go out and use our 20 ranks to learn the rank 10 and rank 20 moves. So we get pyrokinesis and telekinesis. There we shoot him and skips his. Like 6 or 7 second talking scene. Because instead of talking about learning pyrokinesis, he just yells at you.
Oh, great shot. Let's see you do that again. Bingo.
Alright, learn how to throw things. Learn how to throw the run. Alright. So now we have all the moves we need to finish the run. We can skip invisibility. Where am I going? I'm going to the main lodge. Alright. And we gotta go buy our cobweb duster. Because there's 2 points in the run where we need this. One is getting into the next room here in Gloria's mind, and one is the very end of the run in the meat circus, entering that level. Alright, so now we can go back in and actually do this mine now that we learned our moves and bought the cobweb duster. Okay, there. You're supposed to have invisibility so you could sneak in while the door's open. But if you shoot, the animation of Reg shooting, he like kind of thrusts his head forward, and then if you try to talk to her while your head is forward like that, it's actually through the wall, and you can talk to her because your head is on the other side of the wall. So you have a line of sight into who you're talking to, so it works. Alright. So here's the acting level. There's 3 scenes. Start on scene 1. We have to go to scene 3 to get the script that lets us into the end of the level. But luckily we can just fly up there normally you have to change the mood and change the scene and change the script. We just have to run left to right. Goodbye, Hagatha home. And I actually had to go pick up that first script because if you turn in the third script without turning in the first one, you'd get a soft lock, so. You don't need the first script to get the third one, but you have to turn it in to continue the game. Alright, so now we change the mood, and then we're gonna change to the correct script so we can get the heck out of here. There we go, hot air balloon. If you talk to Becky an extra time while you're turning in the scripts, you tell her she's doing a great job, but it's pretty obviously she's not doing a great job. She's just standing there. Alright, boss fight. The candles. Let me just ride the waves up here. All these bosses have 3 cycle. You can't speed this boss up, even if you do extra damage. These dogs are literally the worst. Thankfully, the cutscene of him flying away puts you out, because the dogs like to put you on fire at bad times. I kind of try to land behind him so the dogs don't get to you. Alright. This guy also has, like, the longest dying animation ever, which you'll see. He just kind of sits here and groans for about 10 seconds. Alright, he's dead. Alright. Here's another pretty cool level that I'm gonna skip pretty much all of it and be done in 2 minutes. I really like this level's art style and the fact that they changed like Raz's clothes and stuff. I wish they would have done that in more levels. But instead of avoiding the bull, we can just go over the bull and go to our first mini boss fight, which is pretty tough, if I'm not gonna lie. You know, he gets lots of attacks in sometimes. There we go, okay. Whew. He almost killed me, but we made it. Alright, so you're supposed to have to do 4 of those mini boss fights and go up and down the alleyway a whole bunch of times, but we could fly, so why would we do that? Loading zone's right there, so we can use it. And here's the actual boss fight. Go fight the bull. Now wait a minute. We shouldn't be fighting the bull. The actual boss is this guy. So now we gotta... Whoa, camera. Take the spears out of the bull and throw them at this guy. And throw them against the wall and let them respawn somewhere better. Like that. Oh. Let me just punch the bull to interrupt him talking there and finish the level early. Alright. So into the board game level. This level you actually have to do. It as intended. You can kind of skip things here, like fly up to the roof instead of... It's actually pretty long to get onto this roof casually. So we got the carpenter, so we can build bridges. We go talk to this guy. He says he's not gonna fight for us yet, though. Do a save warp right here. So now we gotta go get him a letter. Letter yelling at him, saying, if you don't fight for us, I'm gonna bust your house or something. I don't know what it actually says, but I'm pretty sure that's the mood. So now he's like, okay, fine, I'll fight. And we make him fight, and he goes and dies, but whatever. He also kills the other guy, so it's alright with me. Build the other bridge. Honestly, though, carpenter's like, he's the best. Now this guy won't fight unless you give him money. All these people want something. I gotta go collect snails for the fat guy to eat. Otherwise, he won't fight for us.
Can't get a good grip.
But I really like the shrinking and growing mechanic in this level. Alright. So now there's just one more guy we gotta fight. But he doesn't have a gun. It's in this building, so. Way to get in here, fly up to the top. And we're inside. Flying saves a lot of time in this level. Even though it's not really a vertical level. Like, there's a whole series of things you have to do to get up there if you can't fly. Or, well, if you do intentional strats, I should say. Alright, go get the fat guy's food. But now, he raised the drawbridge, so we gotta go lower the drawbridge. I don't even know what escargot is. Besides, it's snails. I never remember that name, though. I know it's not snails, but I can never remember what it actually is. Alright, got the drawbridge out. Ah, oh, man, sniped by the cannon. And now we can win. Got the castle. Alright, beat the board game. Alright, now the tower climb. Which this bottom part kinda has some cool movement. The top part is just flying. Oh, come on. I was out and then it like rolled back in. Alright. And then just rats suddenly. These rats explode on you. It reverses your screen, so it makes it really hard to move. It also randomizes what button your powers are on, so basically you can't fly at all. Wow, that's hecka rude powdered milk. Alright. We skip a lot of platforming here by killing your arm and just mashing to hell. Oh. Come on, door. And then, again, we can skip a bit and fly into here. There's death triggers, like, all around that elevator, though, so you kind of have to be careful where you fly. Alright, best auto-scroller ever. Oh, if I can get down. Mr. Pokelope. Oh my god, come on. Look at him go. Oh, this is the best part of the game. It's my favorite part of the game. Yes, Mr. Pokelope.
Careful then.
Alright. And this is the most annoying boss fight, in my opinion. It's not super hard, but if you, like, screw something up, it can turn into a pretty big time loss. Alright, one hit down. And Mr. Pokelope is majestic. Uh-oh. Yep. Oh, come on. Stop targeting the rocks. I should have watched the cutscene of him being happy about the cake, because I'm pretty sure that doesn't lose any actual time. I think that's just like a different point of view of what's happening. Because if you skip the cutscene, he still kind of does that little dance. So I'm pretty sure that cutscene doesn't affect the time. But I haven't timed it. Or actually tried it. Alright. This last level of the game. Here's the elder reason why we needed Cobweb Duster. Alright. So if you remember this level from actually playing through it yourself, there's a really annoying escort mission, but the end of the escort mission is up on top of the level here. I flew somewhere really weird, so we can just fly up to the top and skip that whole section. Alright, so now at the very end of the game, it's just three boss fights in a platforming section. Basically, this guy, you just kite him around until he does that attack and then punch him. I don't know, he's not being very talkative today. Normally it gives you better voice lines. There we go, bun bun bun. Who doesn't like that? Alright, one more hit on this guy. Alright, next attack. Come on. Alright, now the platforming section, which you'll see it's pretty long, pretty difficult. Oh, come on, Rice. Climb the ladder first. Alright. Alright. So climbing the tower. Yeah, keep climbing the tower. And whoop, look at all that stuff we just climbed. Woo. Wee, and we're at the top. Okay. So basically, your dad flies up, and he grabs that swing there. And if you jump up and grab that swing while he's still holding onto it, then your like hitboxes get stuck together, and he keeps like flying up, and then you're inside of him, so he thinks he has to fly up to the next section because you caught up. And so I'm pretty sure that's how it works. It's kind of weird. Well, this last boss fight time's gonna be in like 15 seconds if I get a two cycle here. This guy's okay. I'm getting like good hits here though. And time. I think that's how it works, Milt. That's my best.
Hey, you got a 59.
It's not bad.
I thought it was pretty good.
Yeah, I'm not 100% sure how that glitch works at the end, but I'm pretty sure that how it works is you get your hitbox stuck inside of his, and then as he climbs, the game thinks you caught up to him, so he climbs to the next part. And that's why if you press any button on your controller, you fall out, and you're not connected to him anymore, and that's why it breaks. But that's Psychonauts. The end of it goes pretty quickly.
Hey, thanks for helping me save the bunnies.
But
and for talking to my dad.
Thanks for having me on here.
No problem. Yeah, definitely. Bye-bye. That was an awesome run.
Where's he going? We're
separated. Is there anything you want to show off, or are you good?
He'll be fine. Let's go inside.
I can't think of anything really.
Alright, well, I guess we'll move on to the next run then, which is going to be Shantae and the Pirate's Curse. So, yes.